right, Gene Oakland, thanks a lot as we are set to go with this next matchup here on WCW Saturday night. Two matches, one big segment for you here on TBS.
Yes, I.
Yeah, still to come, we have very special up-close interviews. We continue our look at Mongo, Steve McMichael, one of our broadcast colleagues, and a fixture on WCW Monday Nitro Live. As Eric Bischoff talked to Jim Belushi.
Yeah,
movie star. Big movie star.
Movie star.
Big fan of the Bears and a big close friend and fan of Steve Mongo McMichael. We'll have that coming up in this telecast. Plus, Lex Luger and Sting against Harlem Heat with Sister Sherry. Dean Malenko's here and much more as Todd Morton goes up against the Loose Cannon. Flying Brian, center of controversy, no doubt about it. Flying Brian causing some problems at Nitros. We saw this past Monday live and causing some problems early with Benoit.
Right here tonight on WCW Saturday Night, he done made his presence felt. I'm going to tell you what, we have spoken so many times about how loose this guy was, but I guarantee you one thing, he's not playing with a full deck, and he possesses so much ability. But let me tell you what, I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if Todd Martin slipped up and got him right here. You need to watch this thing close.
Wow. All right, Todd Morton getting the fans behind him here. Flying Brian for the second time in this telecast, waiting to go into the stands.
You know what he reminded me of right there? We big baseball fans. Remember Jimmy Pearsall?
Yes, I do.
Well, he was kind of nuts, crazy.
That's right.
This guy might be a throwback to Jimmy Pearsall.
Jimmy.
When he tried to go in the stand and beat up the people.
Jimmy was climbing the backstop, wasn't he?
Man.
Flying Brian. If this is the new Four Horsemen, then I'm skinny. I'll tell you.
You what?
Forget it.
What was that?
You were reading your format.
No, I was flow mat.
I just don't think.
No, the flow mat.
And the same thing that Kevin Sullivan said earlier. I don't think he belongs to the Horsemen. I think he's more of a detriment than he is a plus.
Well, I thought he was the right choice, but right now he's become a detriment, if that's the word.
He's
become
word.
Silver tone, told you about it. My mama said hello out in Houston. My stepdad feeling great, doesn't have another heart bypass. But I put another one of them things in there, a little box, what do you call them?
Pacemaker.
Pacemaker.
Thank you.
85, I'm going to tell you, just really in a rocking. Out there in Houston, watching them a Saturday night, as the fans all over the world do.
The most watched television program each and every weekend, and the number one televised program year in and year out on TBS.
Wow, got him up here. Oh, send him home with that power driver. See, he possesses all the skill.
He sure does.
You know what I mean? But there's nothing up there as far as what he's got. Look at this. Look what he do. He laid him on top of him just to add insult to injury and then kicked out. The guy's already out. You see what I'm saying?
That's incredible. I've never seen that ever before. Even Randy Anderson said, what are you doing? Flying Brian to face Eddie Guerrero.
You did that. This whole...
Never did that before.
Yeah, no, and when you were at the hotel and you said, go ahead and bring him in and I'd act like I'm dead. Remember that?
Well, Lois.
Oh, my goodness. What is... I guess Todd Morton was out and this is some sort of submission hold.
No, Todd Morton was out from the pile driver. And you see it right here. Speaking of pile driver, right here, Todd Morton is out of it. And then at an insult to injury, he tarred with him until he got ready to nearly rip his face off. The Loose Cannon on the way to pay window.
And he's on his way to talk to Mean Gene Oakland. Gene can have him.
I have nothing but questions, questions, questions for this man you've seen him in action, Horseman Brian Pillman. He's going to be facing Eddie Guerrero this Tuesday night live here on TBS from Las Vegas at 8:05 Eastern Time at the Clash of the Champions. Also, we're going to be going up close and personal with Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. I'm sure that rings the name. But first...
You're talking about the guy in the hospital. The guy that made the mistake of putting his hands on me. Well, look at him now. He's in the hospital. He's got tubes coming out of his nose, his eyes. He can't even call his friends on the psychic hotline.
Brian Pillman, I have noticed, and I watched very closely for it, but apparently all is not well with the Horsemen these days.
Oh, it's not? We've got the power. We got the world title. We got beautiful women. What else is there?
I'd like to travel with you. Another question. Tuesday night, Eddie Guerrero. We've seen this man. I've been nothing but impressed with him from day one.
He's a great athlete, a great competitor. He fights with passion, but he doesn't come from the bloodlines of greatness. He's not a horseman. So Eddie, January 23rd, the moment of truth. I'm going to smack you right across the face. And then the almighty boot of the horseman is going to squash you like, as they say in Spanish, La Cucaracha. And the sun will rise another day under horseman.
I thank you very much. You wonder why they call him a loose cannon. He is one of the four horsemen. Brian Pillman this Tuesday here on TBS. He's going to be facing Eddie Guerrero. Clash of Champions 8:05 this Tuesday and more Saturday night when we come back.